So here we have a Hoover wind tunnel. It's a UH for upright, and then 70400 that has the appears to have either the switch or the motor for the beater brush has failed, one of the two. So we're going to disassemble it. So we've already done a fair amount of the work, so I've popped it back together quickly, and we'll show you how to disassemble it. So first thing is the obvious stuff. Pull the canister off. Get rid of that. Make sure you clean it out. Get rid of it. Pull this out. You just pop this little switch at the back and lift it out. There we go. That's fine. Down here, you want to pop the vent off, the pipe off, I should say, and flip it over here. And to pull off the bottom, this thing is really meant to be disassembled, the degree that they even give you instructions. So there's six screws here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all of which I've already pulled off, and this just pops off. There's nothing to it, it just comes out. So nothing much to look at there, but that's that. And then you can get in and check your belt. You can see the motor there. So now the question is, how do we get to the motor? They can see in this case the belt is fine. So the answer is you have to pull off these screws, or pull out these screws here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws have to come out. And then you flip it over. And there's also, as I recall from doing this earlier, yeah, there's also a little clip right there. So I push down in there with a you know, slotted screwdriver, like this one, and sort of popped it out. So now I've already pulled this off, so this is just gonna come off, but yeah. Now, when you flip it over here, you'll see these screws back on the front and back here. You do not have to pull those off. You can if you wish, but you don't have to. You also have to pull off the three screws here. Now, there's three, as in there's one in there. So that's the one I put back in. Let me just pull that out. Don't worry about that metal clip, by the way. It will go back in nicely. You don't have to worry about it. It can only go in one way. All of the screws here are the same on the bottom here. On the bottom, you do not have to keep track of the screws. They are all the same size and design. So let's just pull this cover off now. Yeah, now it's clipped back in. There it is. So you can see here, that's the cover plate. Get rid of that. And you can see in here, there's the motor. The motor is now loose. You could just pull it out. I'm not going to, but I could. Circuit board. And you can see on the circuit board that there's nothing much wrong with it. It appears to be in pretty good condition. And then that's your power. Under here, there's a little switch that these two white lines go to that tell you whether the unit, well, it tells the system whether the unit is upright or whether it's in use, you know, whether it's tilted back a bit. So that's that. Now, in my case, I would want to test the motor, but before I do that, the best place to start is at the the switch. So I work my way back, and we pull this up, and this is where it got a little challenging. So here, there are two screws. They just pop out. Now, these are different size screws, so you keep track of that. And let's just pull that out. Come on, little fella. There we go. And you can see in there, that's where your switches are, right? Which is not much of a surprise. The question is, how to get this thing off? So so you can get to the connections. If you just try to reef on those cables, which is what I tried to do earlier, you will find it simply will not work. They will not come out. So what you have to do is pull these switches out. Now, just because we're here, let me show you how to pull this off. There's a clip back here, right there, that you push in. And then you also have to pull this little cover off. Okay, so you can simply take a slotted screwdriver and pop that off like that. And you can see it's just got two clips on each side, nothing too radical. So you won't damage that, don't worry about it. And then you would think you'd use a slotted screwdriver. As you can see, I've kind of mangled here trying to pop this up to get into these switches, but you don't. You have to pull the switches out. So on the large power switch, it's on the corner. So you just get a slotted in there and pry it, pop it up. There we go. And hopefully it won't go flying like that for you. If you had two hands, it wouldn't. And on the beater bar switch, it's right there. And again, same thing, hopefully it won't go flying for you. And then badingo, there are your switches. But much more importantly, there's a screw, which I've already pulled out. It's just one of the standard screws, not one you have to take be particularly careful with. And as soon as you pull that out, as soon as you pull that screw up, this will just, you can just lift this off. And you can see how that works. Not being again too exciting. Then you've got your switches and you think, okay, well, I'll just pull them out. Well, you can't. And the reason is Hoover's done a good job and they've used more expensive clips. And you can see I've already pulled this one off. What you have to do is push back the covers. There we go. Just push that back. And if you look closely, you'll see that there's, let's just get that in focus for you. There you go. You'll see that there's a little clip down there. So what you need to do is, unless you've got really great fingernails, is get a screwdriver in there and pop it. And what that will do is unclip it. Now, this is too hard to do with one hand, so I'm going to do it with two, but I'll show you in a second. There, so I've just taken that and popped that. There we go. And you can see that that little clip goes into that little hole, and that's why I couldn't get this off. Now, the way I verified in my case that it's actually the motor that's dead is by shorting these two out. I could have used an ammeter, but I plugged it in and then shorted these out, crossed them to turn the beater bar on, and it did not, which either means it's the motor down there or the wiring. The wiring looks to me to be pretty darn good, so I don't think that's it. And also, this has been put together really well. Good job, Hoover. So at this point, I can either spend about $60 and replace that motor or about $125 and replace the whole unit. So you can figure out which one I'm going to do. Okay, so that's it. If you have any questions, please get a hold of us at www.urtech.ca. Thank you. Bye-bye.